Hello everyone, welcome to the introduction of youth as cultural construction. This lecture is part of your paper on youth, media and society. This lecture will introduce you to the concept of youth and youth culture. The lecture describes the relationship between youth and culture, the positioning of youth in a modern social structure, and how the identity of youth is constructed culturally. The youth in modern societies are no longer perceived only as a demographic category. Rather, the youth as concept embodies the identity which differ from the rest of the constituents of the society. The identity is believed to be socially and culturally constructed. The youth is a stage of human life which preliminarily involves the construction of the identity of the young people in the context of existing social norms. The social and cultural construction of the youth in a society is prompted through the active interaction of the youth with the diverse social realities and components of the society. The media plays an effective role in mediating and constructing the identity of youth by its symbolic representation of young people. The meaning is accordingly perceived by the audience. The advancement in media, science and technology has encouraged young people to adopt latest version of lifestyle. They have learned advanced ways of expressing themselves. This shift resulted in the formation of youth culture, which challenged the conventional norms and values of the society. Let's define youth. Defining youth before delving into the understanding of youth, cultures and identities, it is essential to understand the operational definition of youth as a social category. The basic understanding of youth is the shift of individual from dependent to independent social category in the process between childhood to adulthood. The youth can understand from two perspectives, first as biological category and second as a cultural category. In biological category, the youth is a life period between puberty and parenthood. Youth as a cultural category adopts the characteristics of distinct social role, status and relationship. Scholars in the field have maintained that youth as a social category is difficult to define. The famous philosopher Perry stated that since centuries, the youth has evolved as social construction and the concept has remained evolving. In modern societies, mostly the pre-adolescent individuals are normally considered as belonging to youth category. According to same sociologist, it's rather an individual, its social circumstances that define his social demographic position. In a society, the human engagement with cultural practices and reaction to social norms begin with adolescence. They gradually influence as the individual proceeds in as a young person in the society. The definition of youth also depends on conditional classification that very strong societies. The classification includes economic circumstances, social norms, and working class groups. These classifications on the basis of cultural practices decide the properties and requirement of an individual being called as youth. The flexibility of youth as contested social category make it an interesting area of study for sociologists and psychologists. The noted sociologist Sidhul argued that researchers studying youth have mostly tried to bridge the relationship between modernity and youth culture while focusing less on the culture of industrial and post-industrial societies. Youth as cultural construction. The sociologists at the Chicago School of Sociology were first to adopt the ethnographic approach to the study of youth as subculture in a modern society. They claimed that the youth constitute an alternative system of symbolic meanings that are common among the members of its age group in a society. The earlier understanding of youth being labeled as deviant behavior by the dominant culture was considered as a narrow understanding of the youth culture in youth studies. The foundation of the study of youth culture is mainly attributed to the literature produced by the Center for Contemporary Culture Studies as a University of Birmingham. It considered the positioning of youth in a society as a result of material and symbolic meaning attached to them in a late industrial society. In its current understanding, the use of term youth culture is preferred as the inclusion of the all youths in one culture. The cultural theorist believed that the youth as concept has no universal meaning because it's shifting cultural. Classification and diversity in modern societies. The youth as cultural construct is represented by a meaning that varies through time and context. The Birmingham School moved beyond the conventional ethnographic methods and focused on the textual analysis of media to understand the representation of youth and culture. They largely focused on the characterization of youth in media, which result is moral panic attached to the youth culture in modern societies. The interest of cultural theorists in examining the youth culture has been mainly associated with the social class, conflict in the industrialized societies, but the study of youth culture in non-industrialized societies mainly began the anthropological studies of young people in particular social settings. The development in the youth studies in recent decades has shifted the understanding of youth within static and inflexible boundaries of culture to more flexible and fluid mixed to ideologies and social practices. According to Pearson, the youth is dynamic social construct which appears in particular time and space in the context of defining social condition in a society. He argued that the advancing capitalism in post-industrial societies prompt the concept of youth as a social construct as a consequence of material and economic factor evolved the societies. Youth as a subculture. The distinguished lifestyle interests the behavior defines the youth subculture. The youth subculture is often considered or begin in constructing with the existing dominant culture. Moreover, because of its hostility with the dominant culture and social norms, it is also known as counterculture. Although the subculture theory, which emerged from the Chicago school, dealt with the issues of violence and crime, the sociologist Mike Breck proposed the concept of subculture of youth as an integral part of the modern societies. According to Breck, the classes of the social structure gives rise to collective experienced problem which generates individual identities in a society other than those based on class, education and occupation. The examples of youth subculture can be punk style boy subculture, which is completely different from the culture defined by status or education in a society. The youth subculture is associated with the activities pertaining to youth in various fields. The music genres that the often attributes to youth subculture are hip-hop, emos, reverse, punks, and etc. The youth study of youth culture began with the functionalist sociologist who approached youth as a form of separate culture in itself. The sociologist adopted the concept of anomy, originally developed by Emil Durkheim, who considered society of providing low moral guidance of its individual members. The dominant culture that curtail the youth liberty in a society often instigates the emergence of youth culture with its own self-defined values and norms that most of the time go against the so-called social order. Mike Bark puts forward 5 functions of the youth subculture for the youth. The youth being identified in a subculture can help in resolving the socio-economic problems in particular social structure. The youth subculture provides a collective identity to its members, which is different from conventional identity based on education or parental occupation. It provides space for alternative social activity among youth, which is important for their freedom of expression. The youth subculture opens up space for meaningful leisure activities apart from regular educational or professional works. The identity crisis is resolved for formation of subcultures. Youth as dominant. The research on youth studies has largely been interested in the social deviance associated with youth culture. The youth culture is often related to a deviant behavior that is mostly in deviation from the value consensus under dominant social culture. The noted sociologist David Matja stated that the youth drift between conventional and unconventional behavior, which result in the deviation often reflected in the form of unconventional lifestyle. The youth culture as subculture in the social structure is characterized with social deviance and resistance to social norms. The youth culture as a collective deviance is considered as a strain in conventional social order. and the social system tends to bring equilibrium and the balance by the process of social integration. The media portrayal of youth as deviant elements is considered responsible for creating moral panics related to youth behavior in a society. The youth people are often shown in characters of violent gangs, drug addicts, and criminals, which generate the perception of deviance associated with youth. Moreover, the deviance characterized modern youth as a threat to the moral order and social values. Thus, media is considered as one of the primary agencies through which moral panic and deviant behavior are exaggerated and gets associated with the youth. Hence, the youth as deviant character is socially constructed in modern society, and media plays a key role in the process. The concept of youths. Deviant behavior stems from the theory of symbolic interactionism. It's instead of focusing on macro aspects of a special structure, adopts the approaches of concentrating on the symbolic meaning that people experience in the everyday society. The labeling theory, produced by Howard Baker in 1960, who states that young people who commit small acts of deviance are labeling as deviants in the society. The young people get influenced by the labeling on prompt to attain a deviant behavior. The theory explained the process in the deviance emergence as a socially constructed phenomenon, and this deviant behavior in youth then clashes with the social values and norms set by dominant culture. The noted American sociologist Edwin Lemert in 1974 his study on deviation in youth as social construct identified two forms of deviant acts evolved in the process. Primary deviation. These are the deviant act committed by the youth before the society labels them as deviant. Secondary deviation. The deviant acts that an individual commits as a reaction to his labeling by the society. The deviance is constructed by the societal reaction itself. Youth as a social problem. The youth in a society are often primary targets of criticism by the elder generation on the plans of morality, social values, and order. They are often perceived as attaining the subculture, which comes in clash with the social order and brings about imbalance in the society. In new media, films, and magazines, the youth is positioned as a threat to the social norms and values. The youth is projected as more likely to behave unconventionally and disrupt the social order by not abiding to the social norms set by particular cultures. The young being a social problem has been mostly attributed to changing economic conditions and social circumstances in modern society. The sociologist Simon Frith stated that the youth belonging to rich working class of the society themselves created new pattern of consumption and lifestyle giving rise to what is the called as culture. The negative and risk of this distinctive lifestyle and social behavior are being generally identified as youth culture, which is menosmer according to some sociologists. The youth culture cannot be identified as mere elite lifestyle and clothing, but it also involves youth behavior, interest, and societal engagements. The concept of juvenile delinquents explains the concern pertaining to young people and their engagements with society. According to Boris Johnson, juvenile delinquency is a set of concern about the activities of youth people and their supervision by institutions or individuals representing the social order. The concept of lost generation watch, produced by Daniel and Cornwell in 1993 in their study of disadvantaged youth. They explained lost generation as the youth who feel excluded and disowned in a society due to changing economic patterns and social organizations. This marginalization is a result of social isolation, not because of youth characteristics and behavior. Such youth are considered as a social problem and a threat to social order. The youth who indulge in antisocial activities and exhibit an unconventional attitude in a society are inevitably singled out, that leads to their marginalization. Such youth have been identified as underclass. This youth underclass is perceived as a threat to institutionalized social order. In media projection of youth, the last generation and youth underclass finds a frequent reference and relevance. Although the youth as social problem is a dominant discourse across media platform, the cultural theorist in 1970s challenged it by arguing that youth were not always the passive and vulnerable victim in a society. They tried to develop the relationship between youth behavior and the popular culture. According to them, the culture that is produced by media and other social institutions is highly influential in dictating the terms of social behavior and attitudes for the young people. The researchers in the field of youth studies have approached the youth culture through the dimensions of moral values, lifestyle, and evasion of social responsibilities. The early studies on youth in context of India, titled The Indian Youth, Indian Youth Emerging Problems and Issues, in 1971 by sociologist Prayag Mehta, and Youth and Established Culture in 1976 by Prem Kripal, and among the typical examples of youth being studied as the problems in a society. The mobilization and activism of youth towards a social or political causes are often perceived negatively as a dividend and rebellious behavior. The youth, especially in Asian societies, are judged by parents, teachers, and elders for not keeping up with the moral and ethical values in a society. The process of socialization in a society slowly resets on the social and ethical codes that youth are perceived to resist of regular basis. The media is often criticized of playing a key role in branding youth as troublemakers in the society by frequently portraying them as criminals, deviants, and drug addicts in movies, shows, and comics. The young people are often characterized with violence, rage, and law violation in video games and films. The passive audience perceives youth as the element of evil and problem in a society who exclusively commit the cost of deviance. This negative perception towards the youth is considered of having distorts effects on the social and psychological upbringing of youth in a society. This context on non-conformity and exclusion result in more problems with youth in modern society as they feel isolated from the social structure. Conclusion. Summing up this lecture, we hope that you have understood how the youth as social category is socially and culturally constructed. The identity of youth in a particular society is constructed by the extent of resistance it shows against the set norms and values embedded in a social structure. The youth as deviant element in a society or irresponsibly being portrayed across media platforms. The negative projection of youth often result in negative perception towards youth who are then considered as deviants and a threat to social order. By the discussion above, we can conclude that it's not only the youth who create their own identity in a society, but the social and cultural norms in a particular society are equally responsible for the characterization of the youth in a society. Hope you enjoyed the lecture. For more detail, please read the e-text of this lecture properly and attempt the questions in the end. Thank you.